Hi friends, Radhika Ravi Kumar here. Welcome back to my tutorial. We'll continue with our collection attributes that we were talking about in the last tutorial. So I already gave you an introduction, what are the collection attributes or methods that are available, like first, last, count, next, and all. So, and also have told you how the first attribute will work like. Okay, so now moving on to the last. So last is nothing but it returns the, it's just the opposite of the first. So it returns the index of the last value. For example, if I say var dot last, then we will be getting the, which is the last 1 year, which is the index that is having value, the last value. The last value is nothing but 100, right? So it will be returning the 8. The index of 100 is nothing but it's 8, right? So that's what it will return. It's 8. Okay, then count. So what is count? Count is nothing but returns the number of values in the collection. Returns the number of values in the collection. So what does that mean? That is also very simple. That is, count is nothing but which will return, it will see how many values are available in this collection, like 1 2 3 4 5. So 5 values are available in this collection. So when I ask what is var dot count, the value is going to be 5, because that is the number of actual values that are present in the collection list. Okay, so that's what. And then coming to the next, what is next? Next is nothing but it returns the index of the next available value with respect to given index. That is, returns, I'll tell you what it is, returns the index of the next available value with respect to given index. For example, if I give it like this, var dot next of 2, what will be the value here? So here 2 is having a value. What is the next index that is having a value? 4, right? So that is what it will return, the value 4 here. So that is what is next. Then coming to prior. Prior is nothing but it's opposite of the next. Same thing, returns the index of the previous value with respect to given index. For example, if I give it like this, like var dot prior of something like 8, then what will be our value here? Our var dot prior of 8 is nothing but 100. So prior means it goes back. That means 7 index is not having any value. That means 400 is there for the index 6. So the value will be 6 here. So that's what is prior. Then exists. Hope you guys are following me and understanding it. If not, then repeat the video once again. Exists nothing but returns whether it is true if the value is present in the given index, or else it will return false if the value is not available in that particular index. Okay, true if the value is given in the provided index, or else returns false. Okay, this is what it is. then how this works is when I say var dot exists of something like 2, then it will be returning. See whether the exist of 2 values there. Yes, that means it will return true. What if I say var dot exists of something like 1? What it will return? It will return false because we don't have any value in that index 1. So that is what is exist. And also one of the thing that you need to understand in this is this is what you need to understand about exist. And then we'll move on to the next one, that is extend. Extend is nothing but it will create a new slot, or it will create a new space for the addition of other values. So that's nothing but creates new slot in a collection. This is applicable only for nested and V array. We'll see what are these arrays and all in the next tutorial. So extend. So how do you do this? We are going to say var dot extend. So that means it will extend one slot is extended from there. So that is what is the once it will get extended. And if you can even extend multiple slots, like saying extend of some three new slots will be added to the section, like here. If I say 1, then you can insert see how one complete row got extended. This is var dot extend. If I say var dot extend of some 2 or 3 and all, then it's like this. See, new rows got added, right? So that's what it is. So it's extending. So that's what it means. Then next, moving on to the delete. Delete attribute is nothing but it removes the slot. Removes the slot itself. So that's nothing but when I say var dot delete, it will remove it completely, or one thing. Okay, or you can say var dot delete of some 2 something. That time it will delete if I say var dot delete of some 9 or something, that it will delete the 9th index slot. Okay, for example, if I say 9, that means 9 is this one, right? So how to delete this? Delete cell entire row. So 9th is deleted. So that's how it is. Var dot delete of 9 is nothing but delete the 9th index. So that's what is delete. Then if I say var dot delete of 3, 2, then what exactly happens is from the third slot, 2 slots are removed. Okay, from the third slot, 2 slots are removed. That means from this one, from here, from the third one, 2 slots are removed. That is 3 and 4, I guess, or 4 and 5 will get deleted. So that's how you will be deleting multiple slots. Then the last one, limit. How does this work? Limit is nothing but it returns the size of the V array. So that's what is the limit. So when I say var dot limit, then it will be giving me what is the size here. The entire size is nothing but here the entire size is what, 9 and 10. Here the entire size is nothing but 10. So that's what it returns. Var dot limit is nothing but value will be 10. So this is what is about the collection attributes. Hope you guys have understood. So we'll next we'll meet in the next tutorial. Till then, if there are any queries, then please do mail me, and thank you very much for watching. Keep supporting and sharing my videos among your friends and family. Thank you very much.